The fifth loaf?
Joseph.
Joseph. So today we are going to continue with the our Sunday school. We started before after missing it for 2 weeks because we had Christmas Eve. So we spoke about Christmas and talking about the birth of Jesus Christ and everything took place. Amen. We said that Jesus Christ was the promise of Genesis. It was spoken in Genesis that a virgin shall conceive and the son will be called Emmanuel. Amen? Amen. Mighty God, Prince of Peace, Everlasting Father. So we saw that Jesus Christ was the manifestation of the living God on earth. Amen. Yeah, and today, so we just go back now to our sermon, to our study on the book of Genesis, talking about Joseph, the faith of Joseph, want to know how much faith Joseph had to be one of the heroes in the Bible. And it was spoken about him that in the Bible, Joseph was among the heroes of faith. And the kind of faith he had, it wasn't because he was sick. It wasn't because he wanted more money, but Joseph had faith in God. And the faith of Joseph was the kind of trust Joseph had trusting God. Whatever things was going down wrong, but Joseph was always seeing God. He knew that he was the son of God and everything was working for his good. Amen. So that's kind of faith of Joseph had, to trust God. Amen. So many people today, children of God, when things start going wrong, now they untrust God, or they are not trusting God anymore. They think that God is not with me anymore. Amen. But that's not the case. So we are going to study with Joseph to see how much God he had in his heart to believe in him and to trust in God. Amen. So let us stand for the reading of the word. We open our Bibles in the book of Genesis chapter 39. Amen. As we read together, let us read. And Joseph was brought down to Egypt. His father, Pharaoh, captain of the guard of Egypt, bought him of the hands of Ishmaelites, which had brought him down. Amen. Lord, bless the reading of your word in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. We receive God bless you. Thank you very much. So, we see here that Joseph was brought to Egypt. Amen. So, our title today is going to be Joseph, the subtitle. Amen. Our title is The Faith of Joseph. Are you with me? The faith of Joseph is our title. Amen. Our title is The son of prosperity. Amen. I like this one. Speaking about Joseph. Amen. So in this, we are going to notice something here, what the Bible says. The Bible says, and Joseph was brought down to Egypt. Amen. Amen. So Joseph was betrayed by his brethren. Amen. Amen. So Joseph was sold. So his brethren, they took money from Ishmaelites. Those Ishmaelites was kind of what we call today Muslims, Arabic people. Amen. So Joseph was sold to those people, and those people was doing the business. That kind of business was just to buy people and to sell them as slaves. Amen. So in the same way today, we can go and buy cars, I buy a car and I will sell it. And today, in that time, they were using human beings as cars. So they buy, I'll buy a big boy. So they used to go to the market and big boys will stand there. They will choose the one who has got big muscles. They say, oh, this one costs expensive. Amen. And I'll tell you a little story about what Abraham said about the slavery. But Abraham said that it's not good. But Abraham condemned the slavery, it's not good. It's happened to Africa as well. So people came to Africa to buy black people and they took them to America. They sold them to America. That's the reason you see so many black people in America. Do you know about it? Have you heard about it? That's why you see so many black people in America, they went there as slaves. Amen. So some of them, they are our brothers and sisters. Some of them, maybe they belong to our families. Amen. It's not the same as today we are here. You see black people in England, but everyone knows where it came from. Amen. So when they went to America, they even changed their names. Some of them they called Samuel Jackson, Michael Jackson, and Denzel Washington, Will Smith. So they changed their names. Amen. Beyonce, blah, blah, blah. So they are lost. Amen. So if they could be called like Mutombo, you recognize that, oh, I'm from Congo. And so many of them, they are trying to find their origins. Amen. They are trying to find their origins, but it's hard now. It's almost impossible to find where you came from. It's a big issue for them and they don't like it. So you guys, keep your names. You are Nekaka, everyone knows that Nekaka is from Congo. When you are Malonga, everyone knows that Malonga is from Congo. You may stay here 50 years, generation to generation. You keep the name of your family name, everyone will know that, oh, you must come from Congo. Even if you've got English accent, the perfect English accent, but everyone will know that you came from Congo because you keep your identity. Amen. It's the same today, Satan also trying to hide people's identity. Amen. It's the same. Now, Joseph has been sold as a slave to the land of Egypt. Amen. And his brethren went there. And when those Arabic people went to sell Joseph, his brethren didn't know what took place. In their mind, it was that Joseph died. Amen. So, everything is happening here. Joseph brethren, they don't know anything about this one. This one was happening in the land of Egypt. They knew about it after when they met Joseph. But in this time, in their mind, they knew that Joseph died. So they went to report to the father. They said that, oh, our father, your son Joseph is dead. He was eaten by the animals like lion or the tiger or something like that. And Joseph is no longer living. So, and his father knew that my son Joseph is dead and I'll never see him anymore. Amen. And In that time, something was taking place in Egypt. I will show you something here. The Bible says that, and Joseph was brought down to Egypt. By who? By Arabic people, Ishmaelite people. So when they took him there, they took him to Potiphar, and Potiphar was the officer of the king, Pharaoh, the king. Amen. So they took Joseph there. What happened? Cutting off the guards of an Egyptian. Amen. Listen now. Bought him off the hands of the Ishmaelites. So he was sold by those people. Amen. So after being sold, which had bought him down fighting. So Potiphar was the officer of the king of Pharaoh, came and said, okay, I want to buy this labor. So do you know why Potiphar chose to buy Joseph? Amen. The Bible tells about it. The Bible said, and the Lord was with Joseph. Amen. Can you imagine Joseph as a slave? Amen. He was betrayed by his brethren, but the Bible says that the Lord was with Joseph. So when Joseph went down to Egypt, he had the Lord with him. Amen. Where was the Lord? In his heart. And the Lord was the word of God in the heart of Joseph. And you are going to notice that Joseph in the land of Egypt, even the wife of Potiphar was looking to become Joseph's girlfriend, and Joseph refused it. Why? Because he knew that it's bad as a child of God to never do it. Imagine Joseph in the land of Egypt himself. Amen. No church to attend to, no Bible, no nothing, no father, no brother. But he was keeping God's commandment in his heart. Amen. And by what I'm saying, that Joseph had God in him, that the reason that Joseph was called the son of prosperity. Prosperity means everything flourishes. You do the business, it's gonna work. Everything you touch is gonna work. That's the way Joseph was. Why? Because he had God in him. I like this one. He said, and the Lord was with Joseph. I mean, in the pit, the Lord was with Joseph. Joseph would say, oh my, what happened to me? What's happening to me? But the Bible says that God was in the pit with Joseph. Amen. So when you get in trouble, everywhere you are, anything you do, the Lord is with you. But make sure that the Lord is with you. Amen. Amen. How do you you keep the Lord in your heart? How do you show that you love the Lord? By keeping his commandments. Amen. God doesn't like disobedient people. He doesn't like it. He hates it. Even the parents in the house. If you've got a child who never listen, you never like it. Do you understand? Joseph was obedient to the word of God. To be the friends, God's friend, you must be obedient to the word of God. Everything you do, check with the word of God first, if you have to do it or not. Amen? And he was a prosperous man. Potiphar knew that Joseph was a prosperous man. That means that he was the son of prosperity. So let me buy this slave. Maybe the people will see that the way they used to choose slavers, some of them they used to choose the biggest one with big muscles. Maybe Joseph wasn't a man with big muscle, but Potiphar, when he was looking among the slavers, because there was so many slavers, some of them maybe came from Africa, from everywhere. Amen. So when Potiphar came there, amen, he was just focusing on Joseph. He said, I want to buy this one, this man here. So why? He doesn't have big muscles. Amen. That's the way God works. Potiphar had he was inspired by God to buy Joseph. Why? Because it was the way God designed it for Joseph. Amen. God designed it that way. Everyone must come in his time to take Joseph to the throne of Egypt. And remember, the Bible said that Joseph was a type of Jesus Christ. Amen. He even said that Joseph was the perfect type of Jesus. So when you see everything about Joseph, you see everything about Jesus. Amen. So Potiphar came and said, oh, I want to buy this one. Why? Because he was a prosperous man. And he was in the house of his master, the Egyptian. And his master saw that the Lord was with him, and that the Lord made all that he did to prosper in his hand. Amen. So Potiphar knew that if I keep this man, my house is going to flourish. Every business I'm going to do is going to work. Because this man, not because he's more intelligent than all the people, but because God is with him. Amen. When God is with you, that is prosperity. There's no point to do the business and being a crook, being a crook. Being a crook, stealing people's money to make yourself rich. That's no point. If you want to make yourself rich, the first thing you must do, what? Keep God in your heart. I'm telling you, God is going to give you the prosperity. Amen. Now listen. And that the Lord made all that he did to prosper in his hand. And Joseph found grace in his sight. And he served him, and he made him overseer over his house. I mean, amen. And all that he had, he put into his hands. So now Potiphar said, oh, this man has got God. Let me give him the responsibility of my house, my business, everything. I'll give it to Joseph because I've noticed that he is the son of prosperity. So Joseph took over. Amen. And Potiphar was there. He was no longer working. It was Joseph, the one who was working in his house. Amen. But it wasn't Joseph, it was God in Joseph. Are you with me? The son of prosperity, Joseph. And Joseph was taking care. Amen. With the was taking care of the goods of Potiphar. The Bible says that the Lord was with Joseph after he has been sold by his brethren, yet he was with the Lord. Joseph could say that, oh, God doesn't like me. Why God can allow this one to happen? Why God can let my brethren to sell me as a good? Why? Why God can let my brethren to put me in the pit when I didn't do anything wrong? Why God can allow my brethren to do what they did to me when himself was giving me dreams? Amen. It's not my fault. I didn't do anything wrong. I don't believe in God anymore because God doesn't like me. Why God can do this? Amen. But Joseph didn't ask those kind of questions. He didn't. Joseph knew that God was with him. In the pit. Do you think is it easy? Amen. To be found in the pit and you don't know who's going to take you out. So when Joseph was in the pit, he didn't know what's going to take place next. He was there, he was trying to call his brethren. Judah, Simeon, Naphtali, where are you? Why do you leave me here? He was alone in the pit. Amen. But Joseph wasn't alone. He was with the Lord. You understand? And Joseph, in the pit, he had no food, no drink. Do you know what's going to take place after maybe 8 days or 10 days? You're going to die. Because if you don't eat, you don't drink, for a couple of days, you die. Amen. You get tired and sleep and then die. So there wasn't any hope for him. He said, I'm finished. Everything is gone for me. Amen. It was like Jonah. Jonah was in the belly of the fish. Amen. In the belly of the fish. So, how can you imagine that I'm gonna get out from this place? It's not possible. Can you imagine yourself How can you be uncomfortable in the belly of fish? So when the fish is going to eat, all the fishes will come over you. Amen. And the Bible says that Jonah was praying facing to the temple of Jerusalem. I don't know how. I don't know if he had a compass or what. Amen. In that time, there was a compass. But the Bible says that he was praying in the belly of the fish, facing the temple of Jerusalem. Do you know why? Because he knew that the mighty God, amen, the pillar of fire, the cloud of glory was descending in the temple. So when he was facing there, he was praying to the Lord. He knew that even it is impossible to the human being, but I know that the Lord is with me. The Lord can deliver me. Amen. He didn't give up. And all of a sudden, the fish went to Nineveh and went to take him out. And even the fish was led by the Lord. Amen. Can you imagine that Jonah was sent to Nineveh and he went to Tarshish? Amen. So, how come that the fish will take Jonah right to Nineveh instead of taking him somewhere else? Why? Because the fish was led by God. Amen. Sometimes we think that we've got power to do things. Let me tell you that we don't have any power as human being. Amen. As human being, we don't have power. But the power dwells in the deity. I mean, Jesus Christ who is living in you is the one who has got power and is the one who is leading all your ways. Amen. So Joseph in the pit, he knew that, I don't know what's going to take place, but I know that God is with me. God is going to deliver me. Amen. The son of prosperity. So Joseph didn't complain about what took place to him. Amen. Joseph didn't complain, but he knew that God is with me and in me. But why do you say this? Now Joseph died in Egypt, he goes. And then he was exalted from his prison to the right hand of Pharaoh, and was made to caretaker. Mm-hmm. And everything prospered in the days of Joseph. Do you understand? So when he went in Potiphar's house, he became the second personality or the second boss of the house. Amen. So all the servants of the house was respecting Joseph. So Joseph could say, oh, finally, I'm here. Everything is going fine now. Oh, everything's okay. Thank you, Lord. I know that you have taken me in this place. Glory be to your name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jehovah. Amen. But after that, something took place again. The wife of Potiphar came again to Joseph. Are you feeling? She came to Joseph, you know what took place. Potiphar's wife came to Joseph. He said, Joseph, I want you. He said, No. I can't do it. You are someone's wife. Amen. And she said, I want you. Joseph said, no. And he was trying to hold Joseph, and Joseph was trying to get away from her. What took place? His robe was rent in two pieces, and she kept one piece. And the woman screamed that, come, Joseph want to do something bad to me. And everyone was running there. The evidence, it was Joseph's cloth. Amen. So who Joseph is going to explain? Who's going to believe him? Joseph said, oh, listen, I'm a Christian. Say, shut. Is this one yours? Yes. You are guilty because this is yours. So what happened? How did you get there? So all the land knew that Joseph was guilty. So Joseph could say, oh father, what do you want? What's taking place? I was there as I was in the pit, you took me out. Thank you. I came here, I become now the second boss of the house of Pharaoh. Now, see what's taking place to me. They took Joseph, they put him in prison. And this one, amen, I like this one. Follow me carefully. So, God was trying to take Joseph much higher. He was giving him a highest position, better than the position he had. But before to get there, it must get worse first, and then it's going to get better. Are you with me?
Yes.
Praise God. But the Bible says that when you are sick, and they pray for you, amen? So you become sick again, is the way to get better. So a child of God never ever complain. Are you with me? You can't go somewhere where builders are doing the work. So they'll destroy everything. Take everything out. Painting, everything. They'll destroy everything. When you come, they say, oh, what's taking place? This house was fine. I knew this place. It wasn't like this. What have you done? They had something in their mind. They knew exactly what they are doing. They'll tell you, just keep calm down. Come back after maybe 2 years and you see what's going to take place here. No, I know this place. You start complaining and say, oh, go away. So after 2 years, they invite you. When you come, say, wow! It's much better than the way it was before. Do you understand? That's the way God does things. Amen. God is working in the same way. You see, sometimes things are going bad. You think that, oh, it's finished for me. No, it's the way God is working to take you up. Amen. As a child of God, never ever complain. Make sure that you stay with God. Joseph went to Egypt, to land of Egypt. He became the second boss in the house of Potiphar. Everything was fine, and all of a sudden, this incident came again. So they took Joseph to the prison. Can you imagine when Joseph was in the prison? The Bible didn't say that God wasn't with Joseph anymore. God was with Joseph. In the pit, God was with Joseph. Amen. In the pit down there, God was with him. In the house of Potiphar, when he became the second boss of the house, God was with him. In the prison also, God was with him. Up, down, God's still there. But when we say that, sometimes under the valley, sometimes up to the mountain, and all of us under the blood. That's what Abraham said. Everything worked for good for the children of God. Amen. Just make sure that you are in the word of God. I always think that for the grown-up one, when you get in trouble, you think that is the end. Nothing is going to work anymore. But it's not so. And Abraham said that they were slavers. They were prepared to be sold. Amen. But one of them was always happy. And the buyer came and said, I want to buy this slave. And the owner said, why? He said, the way I see him is always happy. It seems like he's not a slaver. The way this slave is behaving is quite different from others. I don't know why. So do you feel him? Much better than the other, he said, no, he eats with everyone. So do you give him a special treatment? He said, no, it's just like everyone. But it's different, why? And the owner said, I came to find that somewhere back to Africa, this slave here was the son of the king of a tribe in Africa. That the reason is behaving himself as a son of the king. Amen. But Bible said that it's the same for us as well. In this world, you must know that you are the sons and daughters of the King. Whatever was taking place, you must know that you are the son or daughter of prosperity. Amen. You go down, it's okay. So you go to school. Some people, they tell you bad things. You go, oh, why are you telling me? Why are you complaining? Do you think God is not there? God is still there. It's the way up. Amen. It's the way up. You must be strong, because Satan is using that to take you down. Amen. If you tell someone that, oh, like a girl, oh, you are so beautiful. Say, oh, thank you. And someone will come and say, you are ugly. Say, ah! So what takes place? I say, amen. You've been told that you are a beautiful girl. You said amen on that. So someone comes again to tell you that you are ugly. You are getting angry. Why? You don't believe anything. Amen. Don't let anybody to put you down. In the school, you know, in the schools, when we are talking about Satan can become a little child, a big man, a teacher, everything. We see so many bad things are taking place in the schools. Amen. Satan is taking place. So all, the lessons they will teach about sex in the school. Why? So there's no way for us as parents to stop it. You understand? But you must have the discernment yourself that this one is the word of God, this one is not. Take what is good and reject what is bad. Amen. The reason why we are putting the word of God in your mind for you to fight this war. Otherwise, we'll finish those people. Remember, you are sons and daughters of prosperity, because you are part of God. Amen. If you are part of God, that means you are God's. The Bible says that we are God's. Are you with me? Listen now what I'm going to say. For, and Joseph found grace in his sight, and he served him, and he made him overseer over his house, and all that he had, he put into his hands. Are you with me? I like this one. And what? All that he had, he put into his hands. Whose hands? Joseph's hands. So, Potiphar said, I've noticed that you are a son of God. I've noticed that you are the son of prosperity. I've noticed that you are blessed. So there's no point for me to keep everything with me. I'll give them to you. First of all, he trusted in Joseph. There's trust first. He knew that Joseph is not going to tell lies. Joseph is going to be a good boss for his business. He said, Joseph, listen, I trust you. I'll give you everything to keep it. And after month and month, the business was going up and up. Amen. It was a blessing for his house. So he wanted to keep Joseph. But what I'm saying is that everything took place. Potiphar knew that Joseph was innocent. But what I'm saying is that because Potiphar knew Joseph, he knew that Joseph would never do such thing. But what I'm saying is that for his honor, to honor his wife, he sent Joseph to the prison. And if you see in the cartoons, sometimes Potiphar was coming to the prison to visit Joseph. He said, Joseph, are you okay? Because he knew that Joseph is innocent. Why I'm saying that? Because whatever, everybody may not believe you. Amen? But God will keep just one witness, we believe you. We know that you are right. Just keep calm. God is in work. The work is in progress. Amen. So you are the son of prosperity. Don't complain. Amen. Don't believe bad things. But I want to say that if Satan gives you sickness, But my mom said, I'll take it, give it back to him. It doesn't belong to you. He said, one day, Sister Becky was sick. And Sister Becky took the sickness, gave it to Satan. And Satan, take it, give it back to Sister Becky. Becky put it back to Satan. Amen. When you feel bad, you say, oh, Satan, listen, this one is yours. Take it. I don't want it. But when you say that, you feel more bad again. But don't think that the sickness is there. It's gone. But when you say that, if you give it back to Satan, Satan is obligated to take it. Do you understand? Because let me tell you that if I come to you, I say, Sister Rebecca, take this one. Refuse. No, you take it. I said, you have to take it. He said, no, take it. Do you have to take it? You don't have to. But when I say that, in God, there's no sickness. Do you understand? There's no sickness in God. So every sickness we're getting, I mean, even the cold, is coming from Satan. But when I said that, in God, there's no sickness. So when you fall sick, you must know that it's Satan taking it to you. It's your decision to take it or to refuse it. Amen. And you ask me, oh, how can I refuse it? Just keep saying it. I don't want to fall sick. I don't want to. Keep saying it and believing it, and sickness will go. But when I say that, every sickness is demon. Do you believe that? You refuse it. Second, you give something to you, you say, no, I don't want it. But when I say that, every time when someone's sick, if the person doesn't know, you'll be okay. But once it's going to be told by the doctor that, oh, you've got cancer, and the person starts now getting sick. The sickness is not the sickness until you accept it yourself. Yeah. Amen. Praise God. But why am I saying this about Joseph? Now, Joseph, down in Egypt, he goes. And then he was exalted from his prison. In the prison, you know, we'll get to there next time. When he was in prison, he was organizing things in prison. Can you imagine the prison became a place of prosperity? Prison is a place of suffering. Nothing is good in prison, isn't it? Bad people. But, oh my, my. When Joseph got there, the prosperity got in the prison. How can you imagine that? I don't know what took place. Because he had God in him. If Joseph could make the prison prosper, what about the house? What about the business? What about the school? If you have Joseph, you succeed in the school. Amen. Amen. You succeed. But man said that before to go to exam, he said, parents, take your children, pray with them before to go for the exam. It's very important. Amen. And then he was exalted from his prison to the high hand of Pharaoh and was made the caretaker, and everything prospered in the days of Joseph. Now, when Jesus returns, even the desert shall blossom like a rose. Amen. The desert, what do you have in the desert? Just the sand, the water. But today, if you go there in Israel, they're building in the desert. If even some countries, Saudi Arabia to Dubai, is the desert, but today they've got rivers in the desert, they've got food in the desert, everything is changing. Amen. Time of Joseph. The desert will blossom like a rose. He is the son of prosperity, type of Joseph. You want to say type of Jesus. Amen. Closing. They put Joseph in. The general had him in his house. Everything he did, he prospered. They put him in jail, and the world jailer prospered. Everything they did, he prospered. And when he exalted the highest of Pharaoh next to Pharaoh, everything in Egypt prospered above anything in the world. Amen. Joseph, the son of prosperity. And today, you are the son of prosperity. In my last quote, in a message called Sixfold Purpose of Gabriel's Visit to Daniel. 69, listen. He was a type of the son of prosperity. Everything Joseph done prospered. Amen. And when Jesus returns in the millennium, that's the reason the desert will blossom as a rose. Amen. Everything he does will prosper. He is the son of prosperity. Wherever you put Joseph, it was blessed. Amen. Wherever Jesus is, it blessed. So get him in your heart and be blessed. Can we read it together? From there. So
get him in your heart and be blessed.
Get him. Who? Jesus. The word in your heart, you'll be blessed. So a child of God is the son of prosperity. In the pit, you still blessed. In the prison, you still blessed. On the top of the mountain, you still blessed. You succeed in school, you still blessed. Amen. You fail in the school, don't be sad. Do better. Amen. Don't be sad. Be better. It can happen. God can allow you to unsucceed in the school to teach you something. Say, oh God, I'm sorry, I wasn't good enough. So this time coming, I'll do better. So a child of God, you must have distinction. Amen. Show God to the people. Show God to your friends in school, to your teachers. Let them to see God in you. But when I say that, you are the epistles of the Bible. The Bible you see there is only about people. And you are the continuation of the Bible. So let people read the Bible in your lives. Be good children, good boys and good girls. Don't get in certain stuff in school. Amen? I finished by saying this. I was told about it, my sister Francie. A young boy, one day he saw a man coming to him. He said, hello. How are you doing? Okay? Yes. Oh, I've got £10 for you. Oh, thank you. You can buy chips. It's going to be £10. You're going to buy chips. And the next day, the man came again. Oh, are you okay? Yeah. Oh, you can remember. Yeah. I've got £20 for you. Do you like it? Yeah. You can buy everything you want. Yeah, thank you very much. It's one thing. Another day, the man came back again. Say, oh, can you remember? Yeah. Oh, how are you? Yeah. Someone is giving you money. It's a good person, isn't it? But you must know that in this world we are living, there's nothing for nothing. It was written in Google, I think, in Yahoo, things like that.
No, WhatsApp.
In WhatsApp. Okay. It was sent a message. Someone sent a message to her in WhatsApp. There's nothing for nothing. You must be careful when you're choosing your friends. And what took place, one day that man came to him again, said, oh, you see this one? Just little thing this. Go and give it to someone there. If you give it to that person, when you come back, I'll give you £100. He said, wow, yeah. And the boy went there, gave it to the man. When he came back, they gave him £100. He said, wow. And the next time the man came back again, said, so this one, much bigger, go and give it to the same place, I'll give you £500. So, wow! It was a drug. £500. You think that is a good man? No. The Bible says if you want to prosper, you want money, go and work. There's no free money. You understand? Because Satan is everywhere trying to destroy our children. Amen? You don't need someone to give you £500 for nothing when you can get more than that. that person is going to destroy your life. And the boy was caught by the police, and the police gave him 20 years in the prison. His life was destroyed. Why? Because he didn't deserve that person. If you want money, you ask your parents. If they don't have it, they'll tell you, we'll give you next time. You understand? Because Satan is decided to destroy our children. So you are the sons of prosperity. Don't be afraid or don't panic when someone gives you £100. It's nothing. You can get more than that. Just give time, study, succeed in the school, you get a good job. That job is going to pay you maybe £5,000 every month. Do you understand? The success in this earth is in school. The success after this life is the word of God. Sons and daughters of prosperity. Amen. God bless you. Do you have any question? No. Well, we are much in desire.